Lisa Accounting. Welcome to this session of IFRS 16 leases, where we are going to look at Lisa Accounting. Remember, our part 1 was all about the introduction to IFRS 16 leases. Part 2 was all about lessee accounting, don't forget that. Now in this session, you are going to look at Lisa Accounting. Senior Huntington by names. Now the first question. Under Lisa Accounting, one of the question is there a classification of a lease as a finance or an operating lease? The answer is yes. Under IFRS 16 Lisa Accounting, you have to first classify the lease as a finance lease or an operating lease. To remind you, under IAS 17, the old standard, Lisa Accounting, the rules are the same. Even in the old IAS 17, when it comes to Lisa Accounting, you want to first classify the lease as either a finance or an operating lease, meaning that this part is still the same as in IFRS 16. You have to first classify whether the lease is a finance or an operating lease. But what is a finance lease and what is an operating lease? A finance lease is that lease that transfers substantially all the risks and rewards of ownership to the lessee. Lease that substantially transfers all the risks and rewards of ownership to the lessee, meaning that control has been transferred to the lessee. Control has been transferred to the lessee. This means that the lessee is responsible for risks such as insuring and maintaining the asset, but also the lessee has rewards of ownership which come from the use of the asset to generate income. So in this case, if it is a finance lease, then ownership has been transferred to the lessee, meaning that you as the lessor, you don't have control over the asset if it's a finance lease. So what you have to do, you have to recognize the asset. But now, when you recognize the asset, what do you record in the financial statements? Wait. An operating lease. Now, an operating lease, according to IFRS 16, is a lease other than a finance lease. That's an operating lease. A lease other than a finance lease, as brief as that. Don't forget how to define an operating lease. They can ask you classify, they can ask you to distinguish between a finance and an operating lease according to IFRS 16. Those will be free marks for you. Now, how do we classify a lease as a finance lease? Because the starting point when it comes to Lisa Accounting is to classify the lease as either an operating lease or a finance lease. Now, how do you classify a lease as a finance lease? Remember, a finance lease is a lease which substantially transfers all the risks and rewards of ownership of the asset to the lessee. Now, how do we classify a finance lease? Now we have some indicators of a finance lease. One of the indicators is that ownership passes at the end of the lease term. Ownership of the asset passes at the end of the lease, at the end of the lease term, meaning that at the end of the lease term, ownership of the asset can be transferred to the lessee. Remember, you the lessor, you are the legal owner, the lessee is the user. So at the end of the useful life, ownership of the asset can be transferred to the lessee. That is one of the indicators that a lease is a finance lease. Number two, there can also be an option to purchase the asset by the lessee at the end of the lease term. But this option is likely to be exercised at a fair value below the value of the asset at the date of exercising the option. So if there is that option of purchasing the asset at the end of the lease term, then that is also an indicator that the lease is likely to be a finance lease. Indicator number three, the lease term represents the major part of the asset's economic life, meaning that the leasee is going to use the asset almost to the end of its useful life. Take an example. If the asset has a useful life of 5 years and the lease term is 5 years, it means that that is an indicator that a lease is a finance lease. Why? The lessee is using the asset up to the end of the asset's useful life. That is another indicator. Then the fourth indicator is that the present value of the minimum lease payments at the inception of the lease equal or substantially equal to the asset's fair value at that date, meaning that we can get our lease payments, we discount them and get their present value. Now this present value of the minimum lease payments, if it substantially equals to the fair value of the leased asset, then that also indicates that the lease is a finance lease. Lastly, the leased asset is of a specialized nature to the extent that the lessee cannot modify that asset. There is the asset is of a specialized nature to the extent that the lessee cannot modify that asset for any other alternative use. So now you know what a finance lease is according to IFRS 16, you know what an operating lease is, and you also know the indicators of a finance lease according to IFRS 16 leases.
Now,
we need to know the accounting part of it. We are going to look at operating lease accounting. What is the accounting if the lease is classified as an operating lease? Then from there, also going to look at a finance lease accounting. That is, if we classify the lease as a finance lease. In the books of who? In the books of the lessor. Operating lease accounting.
Now under the
operating lease accounting, the lessor, that is the legal owner of the asset, recognizes operating lease income in the statement of profit or loss, that is throughout the useful life or throughout the lease term, whichever is the shorter, but on a straight line basis, meaning that at the end of each year, the statement of profit or loss of the lessor should show an operating lease rental income. Don't forget, ownership of the asset was not transferred to the lessee, meaning that you, the lessor, you still continue to present your asset on the face of the statement of financial position, and mind you, you have to continue depreciating that asset.
Finance lease
accounting. Now, when it comes to the finance lease accounting, ownership of the asset has already been transferred, meaning that you as the lessor, you no longer have the asset.
You no longer have the asset
if the lease has been classified as a finance lease, meaning that you have to recognize that lease the asset from the statement of financial position. Now, what do you record? What you record is the net investment in the lease. You record a receivable which is equal to the net investment in the lease. We are going to see how to measure the net investment in the lease at the inception of the lease. Now, what else? You have derecognized the asset, but you recognize a receivable, meaning that at the end of each year, you expect to receive some cash from the lessee. You expect to receive some cash from the lessee. Now, that cash has a portion of your finance income, don't forget that, as well as a portion for the receipt of the receivable. That portion for the receipt of the receivable reduces the receivable, then the interest income increases your receivable. Don't forget. In fact, under finances accounting, the accounting is a mirror image. A mirror what? A mirror image of lessee accounting when the contract contains lease. What the lessee pays, those annual payments, you the lessor, you receive them as a cash receipt. However, part of that cash receipt, there is finance income. At the same time, there is a receivable repayment. So it's just the opposite of the lessee accounting. Don't forget to record the interest income on the receivable. Remember, finance lease accounting, you recognize the asset from your box of accounts, but recognize a receivable, which is the net investment in the lease. Now, how do we measure the net investment in the lease, or what is the net investment in the lease according to IFRS 16 leases? That part of IFRS 16 is still the same part as in IAS 17, our only standard. Now, net investment in the lease is the gross investment in the lease discounted at the implicit rate of interest. Net investment in the lease is the gross investment in the lease discounted at the implicit rate of interest. Now, what is gross investment in the lease? That is a key term, gross investment in the lease. Now, gross investment in the lease is the minimum lease payments receivable plus any unguaranteed residual value at the end of the lease term. Gross investment in the lease is the minimum lease payments receivable plus any unguaranteed residual value at the end of the lease term, at the end of the lease term of the asset, or at the end of the asset useful life, depending on which one is the shorter. So when we get the minimum lease payments receivable, we add the guaranteed residual value, then what you come up with, the aggregate of the two, is the gross investment in the lease. Now, when we discount those gross investment in the lease using our implicit rate of interest, we get what we call the net investment in the lease. Now, how will we present the information in the financial statements of the lessor? Presentation. Now, for the lessors, if it's a finance lease, they have to present the net investment presented as a receivable in the statement of financial position. If it's a finance lease, the net investment in the lease has to be presented as a receivable in the statement of financial position. Then, assets subject to operating leases are presented according to the nature of the underlying asset. So, meaning that if you have any assets subject to operating leases, we have to present them according to the nature of the underlying asset. That's how we present leases in the books of the lessor. What are the disclosures? Disclosures in accordance to IFRS 16 leases. Remember, in the past session, I told you that the disclosure objectives are to enable the users to assess the effect of leases on the financial performance, position, and statement of cash flows of the lessee. Now, what should be disclosed in respect of lessor accounting, that is for operating leases and the finance lease. Now, if it's an operating lease, the financial statements should disclose the lease income. Remember, if it's an operating lease, you the lessor, you expect to receive annual lease rental income. Now, that lease rental income should be disclosed in the notes to the financial statements. For a finance lease, we have to disclose the finance income as well as the net investment in the lease. Disclose the finance income, net investment in the lease, as well as the changes in the net investment in the lease. What else? Maybe any other information necessary to meet the disclosure objectives including the nature of the leasing activities, how the risks associated with the rights retained for the use of the asset are managed. So any other information, as long as it meets the disclosure objectives, that information can be disclosed in the notes of the financial statements. Exam alert. Yeah, we need to see how can we apply these principles. How can we apply the principles? That is our section of the exam alert. I want to look at operating leases. Banana leases out a machine to Mango under a 4-year operating lease. So meaning that Banana is the lessor and Mango is Yolizi. Don't forget. What is the operating lease term? 4 years. It's an operating lease, of course, meaning that no risks and rewards have been transferred to Banana. The terms of the lease are that the annual lease rentals are shillings. How much? The annual lease rentals are shillings 2,000 payable in arrears. Shillings 2,000 payable in arrears, meaning that the rentals are made at the end of each financial year. As an incentive, Banana grants Mango a rent-free period in the first year, meaning that during the first year, no payment is made by Banana. No payment is granted by Banana. No payment is granted by Mango in the first period of the first year. Now explain how both Banana would account for the lease in the financial statement. Now, as I already told you that Banana is your lessor. Banana is your lessor and Mango is the lessee. Meaning that Banana still has control over the asset. Being that it's an operating lease, risks and rewards have not been transferred to Mango. So meaning that Banana should still continue to present the asset in the statement of financial position. At the same time, the asset should be continued to be depreciated over its remaining useful life. However, being an operating lease, Banana should recognize annual operating lease rental income. Because you're leasing out your machine, so you expect to receive some income from the lease. Now, we see that 2,000 is expected to be payable in arrears, and the lease term is a period of how many years? Is a period of 4 years, meaning that the total operating lease rentals would have been shillings 8,000. That is 2,000 times 4 years. It would have been shillings 80,000. However, Banana grants Mango a rent-free period in the first year, meaning that if you have to look at payments, payments are going to be made in 3 years because the first year of the lease term, no rent to be received. It's a rent-free period in the first year, meaning that our total operating lease income is 6,000. Why 6,000? 2,000 times 3 years, giving you 60,000, because the first year is a rent-free period, meaning that we are going to make payments in the next 3 years. That's why I'm getting 2,000 times 3,000. So the total rental income throughout the lease term is shillings 60,000. 2,000 times 3 years. Meaning that if I want to find out how much is going to be recognized annually for a period of 4 years, we get the 60,000 over 4 years. Remember, the operating lease income should be recognized on a straight line basis, meaning that we should be having the same annual income for the 4 years. So the annual income should be the same throughout the 4 year lease period. So 6,000 over 4 years, you come to shillings 1,500, meaning that in the statement of profit or loss of Banana, there should be annual operating lease rental income of shillings, how much? 1,500. Let me take you to the solution and we see. Suggested the answer.
Mm-hmm.
Lesser accounting income of shillings 1,500 will be recognized without profit or loss for each of the 4-year lease. How do I get that? As I've told you, we get shillings 2,000 shillings, as you can see. Okay, let me take you to my suggested answer and we see what the required accounting treatment is in the books of Banana. Now, as you can see, the accounting income of shillings 1,500 would be recognized through profit or loss for each of the 5-year, for each of the 4-year lease. As I've told you, that get shillings 2,000 times 3 years, that gives you 6,000. But since our lease term is for a period of 4 years, divide by 4 years to come up with an annual lease rental income of shillings 1,500. So at the end of year one, accrued income of shillings, how much? Of shillings 1,500 has to be recognized in the statement of financial position. So meaning that Banana should recognize income of shillings 1,500 in the statement of profit or loss. That is an income, a finance income. Sorry, rather, an operating lease income of 1,500 in the statement of profit or loss. Then in the statement of financial position, this is accrued income. Now, accrued income is a current asset. So accrued income of shillings 1,500 should be presented under current assets in the statement of financial position of Banana. Of which shillings 500 would be released over the remaining 3 years of the lease. Meaning that we are going to be recognizing 1,500 annually for a period of how many years? For a period of 4 years. However, we know that we are going to be receiving 2,000 annually, but we are supposed to recognize shillings 1,500 in our profit or loss. Meaning that over the next 3 years, you expect there to be income received in advance. Income received in advance, because you are going to be receiving shillings 2,000, but our statement of profit or loss shows annual rental income of shillings 1,500. So you expect there to be shillings 500 received in advance. That 500 received in advance should appear as a prepaid income. So it will be a liability on the face of the statement of financial position for the next 3 years. That is your operating lease rental income of 1,500 to be recognized in the statement of profit or loss, as well as an accrual in the statement of financial position in the first year. However, in the previous years, 1,500 should also be recognized throughout, but there is also a prepayment of shillings 500 which has to be released over the remaining 3 years in the statement of financial position of Banana. Now, what about a finance lease? Cherry leases out an item of property, plant and equipment under a 5-year finance lease. The lease commenced on 1st January 2015 and the rate increased in the lease is 4%. The annual lease rentals of shillings 5,000 are paid at the start of the lease period. Cherry estimates that the guaranteed residual value of the property is shillings 400. Calculate Cherry's net investment in the lease. Calculate Cherry's net investment in the lease. Now, this is a finance lease in the books of the lessor. So receipts and rewards have already been transferred to Mango. Have already been transferred to the lessee, rather. Have already been transferred to the lessee. Meaning that there is no any property, plant and equipment to be recognized in the financial statements of Cherry Limited. What Cherry has to do, they have to recognize the property, plant and equipment, but recognize a receivable which is equal to the net investment in the lease. Now, what are we required to do? Calculate Cherry's net investment in the lease. Calculate Cherry's net investment in the lease. That is the requirement. Come up with a Cherry's net investment in the lease. Remember, Cherry's net investment in the lease should be equal to the gross investment in the lease plus any unguaranteed residual value. Gross investment in the lease equals, so the net investment in the lease equals to the gross investment in the lease discounted using the interest rate implicit in the lease. However, to get the gross investment in the lease, get the minimum lease payments receivable plus any unguaranteed residual value. Now, when you look at the question, we see that the lease term is 5 years. It's a finance lease, of course. Commencement date is on 1st Jan 2015. Our interest rate of implicit, the rate of implicit in the lease, that is 4%. The annual lease rent was how much? The annual lease rent was a shillings 5,000 to be paid at the start of the lease period, meaning that in this case payments are made in advance. At the start of every year, they make 5,000 payment. They make a payment of shillings 5,000. So meaning that Cherry receives 5,000 at the start of each year. The unguaranteed residual value of the property is the shillings 400. Calculate Cherry's net investment in the lease. Calculate Cherry's net investment in the lease. Now the net investment in the lease equals to what? Net investment in the lease, we know that this equals to the gross investment in the lease plus any unguaranteed residual value. That's how we get our net investment in the lease. So you get the gross investment in the lease plus any unguaranteed residual value. But now the question is, how do you get the gross investment? How do you get a gross investment in the lease? This was net investment. Let's have a look at our suggested answer. We want to calculate net investment in the lease. Now, how do we get the net investment in the lease? Net investment in the lease. Now, net investment in the lease equals the gross investment in the lease discounted using the interest rate implicit. That's how we get our net investment in the lease. So get your gross investment in the lease, discount them using the interest rate increased in the lease. Now, how would we get the gross investment? Gross investment in the lease. Now this equals to the minimum lease payments receivable. Minimum lease payments receivable plus any unguaranteed residual value. Plus any unguaranteed residual, any unguaranteed residual value. So this is how we get the gross investment in the lease. So we have to get the minimum lease payments receivable plus any unguaranteed residual value at the end of the lease term or at the end of the asset's useful life, whichever is shorter. Then to get a net investment, we have to be having the gross investment in the lease discounted using the interest rate increased. Now in this case, our net investment in the lease is shillings 23,484. Shillings 23,484. How would we come up with this 23,484? Here is the working. Remember, our lease term is for a period of 5 years. But payments or the receipts are made at the start of the year. So you expect that at the end of the fourth year, there is no any other receipt to be received by Cherry, because payments are made or are received at the start of each year. So the receivable balance will be nil at the end of the fourth year, meaning that in year five, you only expect a receipt of the guaranteed of the unguaranteed residual value of shillings 400. So in year one, receipts 5,000. Since the receipts are made in advance, that's at the start of each year. The discount factor for 4%, 0 year, that is one. Then we have 5,000 out for the first 4 years, as you can see. That is 5,000 for the first 4 years. Then the last year, that is the end of the lease term or the end of the asset useful life, we have unguaranteed residual value of shillings 400. That is the only receipt at the end of the 5 years. These are the discount factors which you can get from tables, the present value tables. So you can get those values from there. Then you discount, that is multiplication, to come up with the present value of these payments receivable plus the unguaranteed residual value. So when you discount, we come up with a present value of 23,484, and that is our net investment in the lease. That is how you come up with the net investment in the lease. Now after coming up that investment in the lease, then the rest of the accounting is the same as that of the Z under the Z accounting. Your statement of profit or loss shows a finance lease income. Then in the statement of financial position, you have to recognize the net investment in the lease, which can also still split into non-current and current receivable, non-current and current asset. So you have to be having an investment in the lease receivable, that is as a non-current asset as well as a current, as well as a current asset. So that was our session for lessor accounting. In the next session, we're going to look at a sale and lease back under IFRS 16 leases. Bye and thanks for watching.